Hello.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to today's episode of Senior Lead Presents Curtain Up. We're your hosts. I'm Andrew.
And I'm Emma, and we're bringing the show to you live from our own homes. Now that it's April, I know it's really spring, and spring has sprung, but I've started to think about the little things I can that make me happy. What's something that has made you happy this week?
I cleaned my apartment last evening. It's amazing to, you know, because we've had some warm weather during the days. So I've had my windows and my balcony open, but the, you know, we live in a city. San Francisco is a city and it's still, you know, urban. So there's dust that comes in. So I don't love cleaning, I will admit, but it was so nice to just clean all the surfaces and have a nice clean apartment. How about you?
Well, actually my sister got a puppy this week. She's on the East Coast. I'm on the West Coast, but I keep telling her like daily updates, please. Her name is Penny, and I've FaceTimed her. She's so cute.
Yes.
Oh, my sister's not named Penny. The dog is because she's like a copperish color. Actually, we may have a video of her.
Chloe. Oh.
Oh, that's my other dog too. But yes.
Okay, that just made my day.
So that's been making my day too, every day. And you know, in this time, I'm really looking for the little positive things, but Seniorly has created Curtain Up in response to the COVID-19 pandemic. That is a way for us to feel connected in a time when more of us are really more isolated than ever.
The creation of this live stream has been such an incredible opportunity to connect with so many of you from around the world. Belgium, Portugal, I see you all today, through this art and the music and the conversation. We just love connecting with all of you online, whether it's through your comments on YouTube or Twitter or Facebook or Instagram. During the stream, we are taking comments on YouTube and Facebook. And afterwards, if you're watching later, through all of our social media channels, you can see the comments. So please keep it up.
And keep spreading the word to anyone who you think might be interested and enjoy this show, whether it's through sharing this link on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. Give us a shout out and use the hashtag CurtainUp. And through these links, you can actually see the past episodes, which is great for people who maybe aren't so great with technology. But we have a lot more episodes coming your way and a lot in the past, so just keep watching.
So we're also thrilled to be getting more and more subscribers every day, but we need 1,000 for YouTube to enable us to start using closed captioning, which is really important for so many of our audience. So please keep subscribing to this channel, share these episodes with everybody you know. They're archived on our YouTube channel so we can keep getting subscribers and get closed captioning live.
And with that in mind, if you are live today, and you want to tell us something that's making you happy this week, I think we all need those little positivity boosts. Please share it in the comments on Facebook, on YouTube, and we're going to try to bring up as many little things on the screen as we can that are just, you know, bringing us joy right now. And
Emma, hopefully, we have people in Hungary, France.
Oh my God.
Norway, France, Norway. Portugal, I mean, just, and of course, the United States.
That's incredible. Well, tell us what's making you happy over there. You guys are definitely what's making me happy right now. And for those of you who are watching this at a later time, remember, you can just always watch all of our episodes after the fact. If you get on screen today for a shout out, you can share that with your family and friends as well. And just sharing is a way to keep bringing the people together.
I will do my best to share as many comments on the screen as possible without interrupting the performances. Emma, we've got some amazing performances today. Why don't you tell us about it?
We have such a really great show for you today. We have dancer and choreographer Mia DeWeese. We have Jacob Keith Watson of Broadway's Carousel and Hello Dolly. Valerie Torres Rosario will be singing for us a little bit later, and we'll have a really nice moment of wellness with Ashley Navarez. But first, I am so thrilled to introduce someone that I'm such a big fan of. She's starred on One Tree Hill in the role of Haley, and she's had major arcs on a lot of TV shows, not to mention her amazing musical accomplishments. Please welcome, all the way from Los Angeles, California, Bethany Joy Lenz.
Hi!
Hi! We are so excited.
Oh, thanks. I'm so excited, too. Thanks for having us.
Yes, and we want to introduce your band members to Jack and Benny.
Jack and Benny.
This is a nice little thing now. And you're coming from LA, yes?
Yeah, we're streaming in from Los Angeles.
And we're appropriately distanced.
Yes, yeah, six feet apart.
And so your mom is one of Seniorly's most trusted partners, and she works really closely with senior living communities and with older adults. And I know Andrew and I just love her.
We're
so excited to have you with us today. I know you just introduced your band, so I think we're ready for your first song, If I Loved You. Take it away.
I can't wait to do it. I'm excited about this one because it's from a Rodgers and Hammerstein musical called Carousel that my grandfather was in when the show was originally on Broadway. So George Lenz. So I'm happy to do a little homage to Grandpa George.
Gosh, that was so beautiful. Thank you so much for volunteering to perform today. And as a reminder for everyone watching, if you guys have questions for her or Jack and Benny, you can type them in the YouTube comments, the Facebook comments, we'll bring them up. And subscribe to our channel so we can get those closed captions for anyone who may have some hearing problems with the show. Okay, so a couple of questions. I'm kind of freaking out. I'm such a fan of yours. So you started acting on TV when you were really much younger. What was it like to be such a staple and a fixture on television at such a young age?
I guess it's a multifaceted question, but honestly, we didn't feel, as far as One Tree Hill, we didn't feel much of it. I mean, certainly when I was on Guiding Light, I was 17, I was living in New York City. I had no idea how to appreciate everything that I had, you know, youth is wasted on the young, of course. And then, I got One Tree Hill, and we were really isolated in Wilmington, North Carolina. So we were, as much as we heard the show was really popular and we could see certain elements of our show being integrated into pop culture, we didn't get the experience so much of feeling that like we would have if we were living and filming in New York City or Los Angeles. So it was a huge blessing in a way, because I think it kept a lot of our feet on the ground.
Yeah. And I can't imagine if like social media were the way it is now, how different things would be.
And Twitter and Instagram and everything didn't start until we were in the last couple of seasons of our show.
Wow.
And I remember thinking it was so strange. It took me a long time before I joined.
That's funny. Yeah. Well, much like your character on that show, you're actually a singer, songwriter, an actress. How do you balance having so many talents, and what was it like to kind of play someone so similar to you?
Well, as far as being able to do a lot of things, it's fun, but it's also maddening because it's really hard for me to focus on one thing. I tend to spread myself really thin trying to do everything because I have a lot of creative ideas, but actually getting things done becomes harder for me. But being on One Tree Hill and playing a character that was a singer was a huge joy. I mean, to get to go, we got to go on tour all around the country. We played, I think we played 40 cities.
Wow.
In one summer, and we did a tour with One Tree Hill, and yeah, it was such a fun, I mean, once in a lifetime experience. You know, who gets to do that? It was awesome.
That's so great. And what would be your dream role now?
I mean, I've been dying to be on Broadway since I was actually cast as Belle in Beauty and the Beast in my early 20s, and I had some personal conflicts and just, I had to turn it down. It was like the biggest heartbreak of my life. All I'd ever wanted to do was be on Broadway. But you know, so that's something that is like, I just try and keep dancing and keep singing and just keep in shape so that when that door opens, I can like finally walk through it. And other than that, I would love to go do like a, I don't know, like a Lord of the Rings show or something.
Wow.
On a location somewhere where they put on a wig and I get to wander through like a nymph, a wood nymph.
I can see you more on Broadway than in that picture. You never know.
A wood nymph on Broadway? The Lord of the Rings, the musical. Don't do it.
Well, I know Andrew has some questions for you too.
You? Okay.
Bethany, I'm the biggest theater geek, and you'll be pleased to know there was a Lord of the Rings musical in London a few years ago.
How was it? Was it any good?
No.
I probably could hope that.
No, they tried.
Like they should come to me to find out. Stupid.
You know, I had some questions, but the fans are asking questions so fast. I want to try to pull up some. So just give me, I'm going to look away from the camera. So give me
a second. No problem.
The first one is from Katie R. She wants to know, question for Joy, please share your best musical or your best acting experience, your best memories.
Oh my gosh. My best musical experiences, I mean, I've done a lot of musicals, but I have to say one of my favorites was when I did Gypsy and I played Baby June. It was so long ago, obviously, but you know, it was a really, really fun experience, just a community theater in Texas. But it was the first time I really remember feeling like a part of a family in a show. And I just loved, you know, that my favorite part of doing musicals is the rehearsal time. And you just spend 8-9 hours a day in a sweaty room with all these other people sitting on the floor with their legs out, eating lunch and then jumping up and rooting each other on. And it's just a really, really great experience. I just would do it for the rest of my life if I could. Thank you so much. That's probably my favorite.
I think you have a diehard One Tree Hill fan, because as much of a fan as I was, I don't even know the answer to this question.
Oh my gosh.
Aria Olsen asked, did you ever get your necklace back that you lost during the One Tree Hill tour?
No, I didn't. A close friend of mine gave me a necklace that was her mother's from Italy when her mother passed. And I used to wear it in the show. And I don't know what happened to it. I don't know if it got lost or swiped or what, but I never found it. But one day, maybe after I die, I'll find out.
And here's another fan question. It actually, a few people were asking this. Your musical Pocahontas, is it still in the making?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I started working on this. It's based on the tribal history of Pocahontas, on the Mattapani tribe's oral history that's been passed down for the last 400 years. It's a story that's never been told in our Western culture. And the chief and anthropologist of the tribe finally released in 2012, I believe, their oral history in a book. It's called The True Story of Pocahontas, The Other Side of History. And I started writing this musical about 3 years ago. I have just been working, I'm finishing up with my story editor as we speak, and hopefully I'll be done in the next month or so. And we can start putting together workshops, because most of the music's done. I've been working with Jared Tate, who is an incredible Chickasaw composer, and we're putting it together.
That's amazing. Please let us know when you're ready for us to share it with people, because we will get the word out as well.
Thank you.
Another fan question that just came in, though I think they're really a fan of Supernatural, the TV show.
Oh, yeah.
What is the difference between acting on stage and in front of the camera? And do you prefer one or the other?
It depends. It depends on what I'm doing. I think I prefer stage because I naturally use all of my everything, my whole body and voice. And so when I'm singing and dancing and acting all at the same time, it feels the most freeing to me. But I do love the intimacy of camera. Not that there isn't an intimacy with the audience when you're on stage, but not so much in musicals generally. So I do like the honesty and vulnerability. It just is two different ways of tapping into parts of yourself. So I don't know if I could pick between one or the other.
Great. You know, you don't have to. That's such a fantastic answer. And to all Bethany's fans, please keep the comments coming. But I want to ask some questions now.
Okay.
Totally selfish. What are you doing as a guilty pleasure in isolation?
I'm eating a lot of bread, Andrew. And pie and butter.
And then how long are your workouts after the bread and the pie and the butter?
What's a workout?
you and me both. That's hilarious. Is there anybody in your life besides your mom who we adore, who you want to maybe give a shout out to or say hi to?
I do. Well, first of all, hi, Mom. Thank you so much for hooking me up with this. And it's my birthday today, so it's my mom's birthday, kind of. Happy birthday to you, Mom. She runs a small business in SoCal called A Place for Mom, and she helps families find care facilities and assisted living communities for their older loved ones. Just want to say thank you to all the fans who tuned in. That it means so much to me. To be able to have this opportunity is because you guys show up. So thank you very much.
And I believe you want to share something very special with your fans. You're going to be doing something tonight.
Yes, tonight, Jack and Benny and I will be having, we're going to do an extra few songs tonight with some champagne, maybe wine. You a red wine guy or a champagne guy?
I'll do champagne.
You're a champagne. I'm champagne. Yeah, okay, so we're going to have champagne. And we're going to maybe make some spaghetti or something. And we're going to have dinner and a show. So please tune in with your family. We're going to do some really family-friendly songs. It's just going to be a really nice little treat for your evening.
Amazing. And I believe you have one more treat for us today before you go.
I do. Yep. I can't wait. Thank you.
And Joy will be singing On the Street Where You Live. Thank you, Joy.
Thanks so much. Bye. I've often walked down the street before, but the pavement always stayed beneath my feet before. All at once am I several stories high, knowing I'm on the street where you live. People stop and stare, they don't bother me. There's nowhere else on earth that I would rather. Doesn't enchantment pour out of every door? can be here on the street where you live. Knowing I'm on the street where you live. Thank you, guys.
Don't move.
So amazing. And before you go, we actually have a surprise for you since we heard it was your birthday. So to wish you a happy birthday, we actually have a video here recorded this morning by the residents at Savannah House Assisted Living and Memory Care in Gilbert, Arizona. So if we can.
Hey there from Savannah House in Gilbert, Arizona. We'd like to wish Miss Joy a happy birthday. 1, 2, 3. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Joy. Happy birthday to you. Yay, happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Oh my gosh, guys.
Oh, well, thank you so much. It was such a pleasure to have you today, and happy birthday. And we're so excited that you shared that with us today. Andrew, any last words?
Joy, if you can afterwards, go onto YouTube and just see your fans and how much in love they are with you and your and your love for them. Thank you for joining us.
And we'll be on your live stream watching tonight.
Hey, thank you. Stay healthy, everybody. Mwah. Love.
Bye.
Bye. That was so nice.
That was amazing. And I just thank you to everybody at Savannah House. They weren't able to join us live today, but we're just so grateful that they were able to make that recording for Joy. It was a really special birthday surprise.
And a big thank you to Kim Wood, who's the activities director there. She not only got that video over to us today, but she does so much over there. So thank you for everything you do year round.
We love to always, you know, show everybody the residents at the communities, and Savannah House is particularly special. They have assisted living and memory care. And Kim said to us earlier that right now they're doing lots of trivia and art and bingo. And of course they're making their snacks. They have a theater where we were trying to actually broadcast from today. We couldn't get the technology to work, but we're just so happy they're there. They're healthy. They're happy. Thank you, Kim. Thank you, everybody at Savannah House.
And I think we actually have a little video of them from earlier, too, if we want to play that.
Having some fun.
Wow.
I used to spend my childhood in Florida playing shuffleboard. I know how hard it can be. That's amazing. Thank you, Kit and Nancy, for that clip. Thank you.
And thank you to Savannah House.
That was just so special. You know, I'm particularly excited to introduce our next guest because she is associated with a fantastic Broadway musical, Moulin Rouge. And I was very lucky to see it. It will reopen again when all the Broadway theaters come up again, but we'd like to introduce this incredible dancer, Mia DeWeese.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello, hello.
So I know we're speaking to you in Columbus, Ohio.
Yes.
And I know it can be a little windy, and so everybody just ignore the wind when you hear it, because Mia's performance today is going to just blow everybody away. We're so excited to have you. Tell us a little bit about what's going to happen today, because it's a bit different than what we're used to.
Yes. So I've been trying to work with my quarantine circumstances. I escaped New York about 3 weeks ago and came to my family's home in Columbus, Ohio. And so trying to work with all of the restrictions of being in a house and not in a dance studio or a stage, I created a little contemporary solo for myself, utilizing a prop. And I figured I'd use this nice day and do it outside, make a stage out of my backyard.
that is just extraordinary. We're so blessed. With the wind not in the way, take it away.
Great.
Thank you.
She's got them bad. She feels so sad and wants the world to know just what her blues is all about. Lady sings the blues. She tells her sad, nothing to hide. Now the world will know just what the blues is all about. 'Cause the blues is nothing but pain in your heart when you get a bad start, when you and your man have to part. Ain't gonna just sit around and cry. I know I won't die. 'Cause I love him. Lady sings the blues. I'm telling you, she's got a man. But now the world will know she's never gonna sing them no more. No
That was, can you hear me, Mia?
Yes, I can.
Wow, that was beautiful.
Thank you.
Thank you for choreographing that and for sharing that with us. I'm just blown away. That's our first official dance piece.
Oh, wow.
You've worked as a choreographer. I know you work with Sonia on many projects like Moulin Rouge and Rent Live. What's it like working with a choreographer on a theater project versus working on a TV project like Rent Live?
I would say for theater, it's a much longer process. So like with Moulin Rouge, for instance, we started with a lab, then we had an out of town, then now we're on Broadway. And so you have a longer arc of creation. It's a lot of, and also we did a lot of pre-production. So we were in the studio a lot, just doing a lot of prep work with TV, with television and with Rent Live. Especially, it's so fast. The process was so fast. I mean, we did some prep work for that too, but by the time we got to Los Angeles and started rehearsals, there was only about 3 weeks of rehearsals before we were into the sound stage and starting camera blocking and everything. So it's just a lot faster and rapid.
How did you first become involved in dance?
I danced as soon as I could walk, basically. No one in my family were big dancers. My grandmother, actually, she used to do the jitterbug with her brother back in West Virginia. But other than that, I don't really have any dancers in my family. But I just had an affinity to dance, and my mom stuck me in classes, and I kept going.
And other than working with Sonia, are there other choreographers that have inspired you?
Yeah, I mean, I have like three female mentors that have all been amazing to me and inspired me along the way. One is Brooke Perotti. She's actually Sonia's best friend. That's how I met Sonia. So Brooke has been a big inspiration. And then obviously Sonia. I've been a part of her journey for a while and it's been amazing. And then I have another female friend, Jen Freeman, who owns a contemporary, she's the artistic director for a contemporary dance company. And I met her through Sonia as well. And she's a huge inspiration also.
I just have to get this up on the screen. Samina asked, for how long do you warm up? And also, do you rehearse for dancing choreography like this?
Yeah, I am historically terrible at warming up, but I'm starting to feel that in my bones and in my body. I throw out my neck like once a week. So yeah, I try to warm up. I would say a good, decent warm up to performing a piece like this would be like a half hour just to get my body engaged and involved and things like that.
Please keep warming up. We want you around for as long as
possible. I know. I'm working on it. That's definitely a goal of mine, is to be better about warming up and taking care of myself.
You told us before we were on the air tonight that you have somebody that you want to give a shout out to.
Yeah, I mean, I would love to give a shout out to my grandfather, who I'm actually quarantined with. He's upstairs in my family room. And he is 92. And it's actually been kind of a blessing to spend this time. I would have never had this time home in Ohio had it not been for this outstanding circumstance. So it's been fun to get to hang out with my 92-year-old grandfather during this time. And I think he's watching upstairs. So
we are all so fortunate to have to spend this time with those closest to us.
Yeah.
So I'm so glad we were able to share this moment with you, and you can share your gift with so many people watching today. I know Moulin Rouge will be open again soon on Broadway. So everybody, please, when Broadway reopens, go see Moulin Rouge. It is a feast for the eyes and the ears and the heart.
Yes, it is.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Mia.
Thank you so much for having me. I really appreciate it.
Emma, how amazing was that performance?
That was so good. You know, the dancing in Moulin Rouge is like the best part, and it was so cool to have her dancing.
It's all really
anyway,
good.
It was, of course, but that was just really cool. And we have even more coming, so it's very exciting. But a little reminder, if people want to comment about the things that are making them happy this week, throw it in there. We'll put them up. The shout outs are great too. So just keep chatting in the comments.
And I'm seeing all the comments. I am seeing them. I was trying to coordinate between speaking and going back and forth. But if you liked Mia's performance today, do we have a special treat? We have something else that's really unique, an exciting new segment we're trying today, inspired by movement. So please welcome Ashley, who is calling in from Colorado to lift our spirits and guide us through a few exercises.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Great. You can take it away.
Great. Well, thank you so much for having me. I'm honored to lead you guys through some chair yoga today. So wherever you are, all you need is a chair to do these movements we're going to move through. But as with any exercise program, please be careful and only follow along if you have a good range of motion. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's take a tall seat. Drop your shoulders down away from your ears. And if you feel like closing your eyes, please close your eyes and start to focus on your breath. Start to focus on big, deep inhales, filling your lungs with air. And a very slow exhale with slightly parted lips. Let's move through a couple more of those. Two more. Inhale through your nose. And exhale. One more together. Inhale through your nose and exhale. So let's start to raise our arms all the way up above, bringing palms together like you're squeezing a beach ball above your head. Squeeze your shoulder blades back and together like a string is pulling you from the top of your head. And exhale your arms all the way down. Inhale, arms all the way up and all the way down. One more time. Inhale all the way up and slowly twisting over one shoulder. Bring one hand towards the outside of your opposite leg and just find a gentle twist in your torso. Inhale all the way back to center. Arms come high. And exhale, twist over opposite shoulder. Inhale, back to center, arms come high. And twist again with the exhale. Inhale, back to center. And exhale. Inhale once back to center and hands come down onto your lap. So let's start with some shoulder rolls, bringing shoulders back, big circles. Get two more big circles in. And slowly start to bring them forward. Two more. Hands are planted on your lap and start to curl your upper back, kind of like you're hunching over as if your shoulders are making a kiss on the ceiling. And then squeeze them back like you're pinching a $100 bill between your shoulder blades. Squeeze and round towards your lap and lift your heart to the sky. One more round and lift your heart to the sky. Nice work, you guys. Take a tall seat once again. Bring one ear towards your shoulder. Find a stretch in this side of your neck, maybe a little bit into your shoulder. And inhale back to center. Exhale, let's switch sides. Inhale back to center and exhale, pin your ear towards your shoulder. Inhale to center and exhale, pin your ear. Inhale back to center and start to find some rolling neck movements. In one direction, let's find three full rolls all the way, chin dropping down to your chest, and gaze all the way up. Once you've completed that side, start to move opposite direction, moving through any tension that you might feel in your neck, your shoulders. And don't forget to breathe. Really important to breathe. Bring it back to center. So we're gonna squeeze our shoulders all the way up next to our ears. Take a big deep inhale, squeeze, 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 and exhale, drop them away. Two more. Inhale, squeeze, and exhale. And one more squeeze, as tight as you can. And exhale. We've got one more exercise to do. So we're gonna take our palms up towards the sky and start to fist your hands into a tight little ball. Every anxiety that you're feeling, stress you're feeling, start to squeeze them into tight little balls in your hands and squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Take a big deep inhale and exhale. Let your hands open up to the sky. Inhale, squeeze. And exhale. One more. Inhale, squeeze. And exhale. Let's do two more big, deep inhales and exhales together as a community. Inhale, arms all the way to the sky. And exhale. All right, this is our last one. Make it good. Inhale, arms all the way to the sky. And exhale. Thank you guys so much. I hope you take some of these exercises with you through the rest of your week and through your weekend. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you, Ashley. It was so great to have you. Bye. And we actually have some more great performances lined up. Wasn't that great though? I actually participated back here. And I think I'll keep trying it. But next up we have Jacob Keith Watson and he's joining us from New Jersey.
Hi.
And I believe for your first song, you'll be singing Almost Like Being in Love.
That's right.
Okay, take it away.
What a day this has been. What a rare mood I'm in. Why, it's almost like being in love. Got a smile on my face for the whole human race. Why, it's almost like being in love. All the music of life seems to be like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when the bell, when it starts to peal, I could swear I was falling. I would swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love. Hey, it's just like being in love. Oh, it's just like being in love. All the music of life seems to be just like a bell that is ringing for me. And from the way that I feel when the bell starts to peal, I would swear I was falling. I could swear I was falling. It's almost like being in love.
Woo, that was amazing.
Thank you.
So awesome to watch you, and I love that backdrop.
Ah, yeah. It's our nice little accent wall wallpaper in the office.
It's beautiful.
Thank you.
I think you have a second song.
I do.
It kind of goes with the backdrop. Younger than springtime.
That's right. I touch your hands and my arms grow strong, like a pair of birds that burst with song. My eyes look down at your lovely face, and I hold the world in my embrace. Younger than springtime are you, sweeter than music are you, warmer than winds of June are the gentle lips you gave me, gayer than laughter are you, sweeter than music are you, angel and lover, heaven and earth are you to me. And when your youth and joy invade my arms and fill my heart as now they do, then younger than springtime am I, gayer than laughter am I, angel and lover, heaven and earth am I with you. And when your youth and joy invade my arms and fill my heart as now they do, then younger than springtime am I, gayer than laughter am I, angel and lover, heaven and earth am I.
Wow, that was so good. You have such a powerful voice. That was amazing.
Thank you.
Great. I have some questions for you.
Of course.
Oh, wow. Kids asleep beside me, a cup of hot tea. Oh, these are people saying their shout out for happiness.
I have a cup of hot tea right back over there, too.
Oh, amazing.
Right.
So So actually, I know you've been in some incredible Broadway revivals, including the production of Carousel, which is cool. Bethany Joy Lenz mentioned that earlier. Their grandfather was in that. And Hello, Dolly, which starred Bette Midler. And you're often working on original productions like Amelie and the upcoming musical Swept Away. What is it like kind of working on a revival from a new musical? I think they're pretty different.
Yeah, they're quite different. I mean, there's a ton of differences, but probably the biggest difference with the revival, you're not doing it unless it probably already works. And so you're trying to find a new way to do it, and you're finding a new way to connect that with a new audience for whatever reason you feel necessary to tell that story in that time period. Whereas with the new musical, you're trying to figure out how to make it work, how to tell that story as clearly and impactfully as possible. So that's kind of the biggest difference between the two.
Which one is more nerve-wracking?
Oh, well, I think they both come with equal amounts of nerves. With revival, everybody has a way they want to see it done. And with the new musical, everybody thinks the new musical should be like X or Y. So there's expectations and nerves with both of those.
Well, you seem very calm and collected today. And for all of our home chefs out there, we actually heard that you're great with barbecuing. What's your secret to a great barbecue?
Yeah, so being an Arkansas boy, the kind of barbecue I grew up on is dry rub, which comes from the Memphis area. So for me, the secret to the great barbecue is that I shouldn't have to use a barbecue sauce to make it taste good.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I don't know. That's surprising to me. That's exciting.
Yeah, the idea is like if there's no sauce, then all that's there is the original seasoning and then how well you cooked it.
Oh, wow. Are you barbecuing now?
Not today, but I did smoke a turkey 2-3 days ago.
Amazing. I wish I were quarantined over there. I also hear you are an amateur woodworker, which is a pretty cool hobby. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, so it's interesting. I never thought of myself as someone who would create in that way. I always thought of myself as a performer, a singer, actor. And then all through my childhood, my grandfather had this shop in their basement. And it was full of like, there was like a big room full of wood. And then there was all these tools all throughout this room. And I was always so interested in it. I didn't know very much about building anything, but I was always so intrigued by it. And so cut to, you know, high school, I built some of the sets with the plays that I was doing. In college, I actually worked in the set shop as a builder, a construction guy, carpenter, if you will, for my work study. And then so it kind of continued on from there. And so nowadays I build, we don't have a very big shop out back, but I for Christmas this last year, I built everybody in my family cutting boards.
Oh.
So I build little things like that, little fun stuff like that.
That is so fun. Wow. Yeah. And what a nice connection with your grandfather. That's lovely.
Yeah.
So we're actually excited. You have one more for us today.
I do.
So thank you so much for taking this time. You're so incredible to watch. And your next performance is Sit Down, You're Rocking the Boat.
I dreamed last night I got on the boat to heaven. And by some chance I had brought my dice along. And there I stood. And I hollered, hey, someone fade me. But the passengers, they knowed right from wrong. For the people all said, sit down, you're rocking the boat. People all said, sit down, you're rocking the boat. For the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapels round your checkered coat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. I sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my fist, and there I stood, nicely passing out all the whiskey. But the passengers were bound to resist, for the people said, beware, I'm on a heavenly trip. Oh, people all said, beware, beware, you'll scuttle the ship. For the devil will drag you under by that fancy tie around your wicked throat. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven. A great big wave came and washed me overboard, and as I sank, and I hollered, hey, someone save me. That's the moment I woke up. Thank the Lord. And I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. For the devil will drag you under with a soul so heavy you'd never float. Sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down, you're rocking, sit down, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down, you're rocking, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Sit down.
Woo! That was awesome. I always wonder, what do people's neighbors think if they can hear you singing so loud?
Thankfully, there's just enough distance, but if he's out mowing the lawn, he might hear me.
Well, thank you so much for coming today. That was really amazing, and we're so glad we got to have you on.
Thanks for having me.
Bye. Have a great rest of your day.
See you.
And we have one more special performer today, Valerie Torres Rosario from Gainesville, Florida. Welcome to the screen.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
Oh. How are you doing? Is it hot?
Delightfully so. I really like the warm weather, so I'm happy to not be cold. Wearing a turtleneck for the season, I suppose. But
great. Yeah. Well, we have a couple of questions for you.
Yes. I first of all, I watched you doing the yoga during the yoga session with Ashley. That was fantastic. And so I was like, oh my God, I should do it. Thank you for doing it. We're all under isolation, and Emma and I are asking each other, what are you doing? So Valerie, what are you doing under isolation?
I am teaching myself the piano. I'm looking into musical histories. I'm also diving into operas and just spending time with family, honestly, and trying to make the most of that.
Is there any family members you want to give a shout out to?
My abuela in Puerto Rico. I love and miss her so much. I was fortunately able to see her back in December for her 80th birthday.
Wow. Well, this recording will be saved on YouTube, so feel free to share this with her afterwards.
Yay.
And just for your abuela and for all of us, you have a very special treat, one of my favorite songs, Journey to the Past.
Yeah. Heart, don't fail me now. Courage, don't desert me. Don't turn back now that we're here. People always say life is full of choices. No one ever mentions fear or how the world can seem so vast on a journey. The past. Somewhere down this road, I know someone's waiting. Years of dreams just can't be wrong. Arms will open wide, I'll be safe and wanted finally home where I belong. Well, starting now, I'm learning fast on this journey to the past. Family, there was once a time I must have had them too. Home of family, I will never be complete until I find you. one step at a time, one hope then another, who knows where this road may go. Back to who I was, on to find my future, things my heart still needs to know. Yes, let this be a sign, let this road be mine, let it lead me to my past and bring me home.
Wow. Wow. I'm like speechless. That's just stunning. That's a hard song. That's just stunning. There are a lot of people leaving comments for you. And during your next song, I'm going to flash some of those comments on the screen. So let's take, I'm not going to waste any more time. From the Pixar movie, Coco, take it away.
Yes. This one's a special one. I'm also waiting for it to load. Oh, here we go. Recuérdame. Hoy me tengo que ir, mi amor. Recuérdame. No llores, por favor. Te llevo en mi corazón y cerca me tendrás. A solas yo te cantaré soñando en regresar. Recuérdame. Aunque tenga que emigrar, recuérdame. Si mi guitarra oyes llorar, ella con su triste canto te acompañará hasta que en mis brazos estés. Recuérdame. Thank you guys so much.
Wow. Thank you for sharing that. I just want to get that. Try to get one more comment on the screen before you go, but I'm not moving fast enough. It's hard. Ali says you're gorgeous, and she means your voice is just magnificent. Thank you for joining us today.
Thank you. Thank you for allowing me to share. This is wonderful.
Thank you. Well, Emma, that was such a day of performances. I'm just so overwhelmed. What a show. You're on mute. Yeah, it happens.
No, thank you everyone from all of us at Seniorly for joining us today. And please subscribe to our YouTube channel so we can enable that live closed captioning. We need 1,000 subscribers to make it happen.
Spread the word on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram. Use that hashtag, curtain up. And if you posted your shout out on the air today, make sure to take the link from today's video and share it with everybody you know.
And a special thanks to all of our guests with this jam-packed episode, Bethany Joy Lenz, Mia DeWeese, Jacob Keith Watson, Valerie Torres Rosario, and thank you to Ashley for the chair yoga, and a special thank you to the residents at Savannah House for sending over that lovely video. Thank you also to Chloe and Erica in the broadcast booth, and join us tomorrow for a special performances by Aaron Lazar, Ian KD, Molly Hager, Nicholas Lung, and Simon Longnight.
We are doing
another jam-packed one.
Yes, it's a big one. We are doing this for senior living communities across the country and for seniors who are at home. You are not forgotten. You are loved. We'll be back tomorrow to entertain you.